testify. May we be just like a child, staring at the beauty of our King. May we never lose our wonder. May we never lose our wonder. Wide-eyed and mystified, just like a child, staring at the beauty of our King. Staring at the beauty of our King. Holy, captivated. Fascinated, wholly captivated by the beauty of a King. You tear off the veil from our eyes tonight. You let these scales fall from our eyes, that we would see you, God. We would see. May we be just like a child, staring at pacified. May we be just like a child, staring at the beauty of our King. You are beautiful in all your ways. Oh, you are beautiful in all your ways. Oh, you are beautiful in all your ways. Oh, you are beautiful in all your ways. Yes, you fascinate me. You fascinate us. You fascinate us with your love. You fascinate me. You fascinate us. You fascinate us with your love. You fascinate. is this that commands the worship of angels? 10,000 times 10,000 caught up in the beauty, caught up in the glory. Who is this? Saints and the elders around the throne, day and night, night and day, cast their crowns before the Lord. Oh, who is this? this King of glory is just the very beginning. For everything we think we know, everything we think we've seen, it's just the beginning. It's just the King of God who inhabits the praises of your people. So make this your dwelling place. Make this your dwelling place. Make this your dwelling place. Would you make this your dwelling place?
His love is victorious.
is for us. His love is victorious. Revival is rising. It is there. Well, the King is among us. His glory surrounds us. His fire is falling as we sing. Savior is for us. Spirit of adoption, we say Abba Father, we say Abba Father. Spirit of adoption, we say Abba Father, we say Abba Father. I am a child of God, 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 I am a child.
Father, we thank you that in this place tonight, the very fact that we can approach your throne and come to the place of prayer and worship is not because of anything great we have achieved or accomplished, but it's simply because of the fact that you call us children. And Father, that we have been given this title by grace and by grace alone. So God, remind us once again, Father, we can't bring this place, bring our place to this, bring ourselves to this place of understanding on our own, but God, it is only by your Spirit, Father, that we are able to have understanding of this truth and have deeper revelation of what this truly means to us. And so God, we come to you humbly. God, we come to you in meekness, desiring, God, that you would continue to, by your Spirit, God, impart this kind of knowledge onto us. In your son's most precious name we pray, amen. At this time, we'll transition into a time of worship in the Word. And today, we'll be meditating on and praying through Matthew 5, verses 11 through 16. I invite you to open your Bibles and join us as we pray, meditate, and sing through this passage in smaller segments. So once again, the passage is Matthew 5, verses 11 through 16. Once again, the passage is Matthew 5, verses 11 through 16. Matthew 5, 11. Blessed are you when others revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Father, we thank you that your kingdom is utterly countercultural, and that what the world sees as loss, you see as gain. God, what the world sees as failure, you see as redemption. God, what the world sees as defeat, you see as victory. Father, we thank you that even when we are reviled and persecuted, and even when we are slandered with accusations that are not true of us, God, you call us blessed. Father, you call us blessed. And we are not blessed based on any account of our self-earned achievements, but simply because you call us blessed. And it is enough that this is what you call us. Father, simply hearing your voice is enough. Hearing your affirmation is enough. And so, Father, we thank you that we are blessed, that even when we are reviled and persecuted for your name's sake.
We live to please you, God, and please you, Lord. Thank you. fix on
satisfying, and because you are that much more beautiful. Help us to be utterly satisfied in you and knowing that our reward is in heaven. God, we do not live our lives for what we will earn in this life, but God, we live our lives for we know that our reward is great in heaven.
For there is a reward, there is a reward that the world does not know. The world does not know us.
See you face to face. It's to see you face to face. It's to see you face to face.
through trials and even through testing, we will rejoice and be glad in the Lord. Even through trials and even through testing, we will rejoice. We will be glad in the Lord. Even through trials and even through testing, we will rejoice. We will be glad in the Lord. Even through trials and even through testing, we will rejoice. We will be glad in the Lord. Even through trials, even through testing, we will rejoice. We will be glad in the Lord. Even through trials, even through testing, we will rejoice. We will be glad.
Father, you call us to be the salt and the light of this world. You say, if salt has lost its taste, how shall its saltiness be restored? You also say, a city on a hill cannot be hidden. Likewise, if we do not live out our identity and who you call us to be, we are but robbing ourselves from living out in the fullness of our destiny, and that is to be a blessing. Even in moments where we feel like we do not see tangible results, immediate fruitfulness, or the fulfillment of our personal expectations, God, we acknowledge that it is not about ourselves, for our identity is not rooted in anything else but you. So help us to live out our calling as the salt and the light. Help us to not hide from what you have given to us. And God, that is the very truth of the gospel. God, help us to live out in love by both word and deed.
All the world will see a people fully satisfied. fully satisfied in you. They will have no fear. They will have no fear. Oh, these people satisfied. Oh, these people satisfied in you. Even through trials, even through testing, oh, they will rejoice. And the world will see, oh, the world will see, there is one who is worthy of it all. The world will see, the world will see, that there is one who is worthy of it all. So set your city upon a hill. Set your city upon a hill. Set your city upon a hill. That the world set your city upon a hill. Would you set your city upon a hill? Would you set your city upon a hill? Oh, that the world would know you are worthy of it all. Would you set your city upon? Set your city upon a hill. Oh, would you set your city upon a hill? That the world would know you are worthy of it all. Would you set your city upon a hill? Would you set your city upon a hill? Set your city upon a hill, that the world would know you are worthy of it all. 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 Satisfied in you. You are worthy of it all. 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 Even through testing, we will declare that you are worthy. You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all.
verses 15 to 16. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to God your Father who is in heaven. Father, we ask that as we live out our identity as salt and light, and who you have called us to be, we would know that all is for your glory. When people see our good works, it is for people to give glory to you, Father. It is not for the sake of our recognition, but for the sake of people praising your name and acknowledging fully who you are. Father, we ask that this may be the ultimate motivation in what drives us forward. Lord, in living out our lives before you, and God, before people, that truly when they see us and the manner by which we live, Father, immediately that they would recognize you, not us, but you. So God, continue to work in and through us, that your glory may be displayed in our lives.
That all glory would be to you, O God. Let them see and let them know.
You want to lay others to you, that then they would know you, that they would love you.
Let your light be revealed.
Silent, we will not be silent, for the world will know you are God.
We will share this amazing love that you've given to us first. We'll share it with all of our friends and all of our family and all of our workplace.
It's gonna be worth it. gonna be worth it all. It's gonna be worth it. It's gonna be worth it. It's gonna be worth it all. Oh, I believe it. I believe it. When I see your face, it's gonna be worth it all. Even through trials and tribulations, when I see your face, it's gonna be worth it all. I believe it. I believe it. When I see your face, it's gonna be worth it all. Even through trials and tribulations, when I see
this time we'll continue praying for North Korea through intercession topics. And today we'll specifically be praying for restoration over the land. And as I pray through the topics shown on the screen, please come into agreement with me and follow along by lifting up your own intercession. Father, we pray for the restoration of prayer and worship in the nation of North Korea. Not prayer and worship to man, false gods, nor idols, but prayer and worship that is wholly devoted to you and you alone, no one else but you. And may you lead people to come to you and speak to you, God, the joys and groanings of their hearts through prayer. May you lead people to come to you and sing to you praises and adoration through worship. May you cause them to seek after you and your face, not just after your hand of blessing, but your face, through which, as you say in your word, is displayed the knowledge, the light of the knowledge of you. God, raise up worshippers and intercessors who will minister to you. And as prayer and worship is restored, Father, we ask that you would forgive the sins of the land and heal it, that you would sweep across the nation of North Korea, and that you would move and that you would heal this land. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Father, as prayer and worship increases and abounds in the nation of North Korea, we ask that in turn you would incline your ears towards them and be attentive to their cries. Do not leave your people be, but as they turn to you, turn to them also. And Father, we ask that you do this by pouring out more of your Spirit. Father, we prophesy that as you pour out your Spirit, that it is in your presence there will be greater healing, salvation, and revival. Let's pray.
Revival, revival, establish the fullness of your reign, establish the glory of your name, revival, revival, establish the fullness.
Worship, prayer, and the preaching of your word that is taking place in church gatherings each week, that these things would not cease, but that it would only continuously multiply and increase. Father, we know that your saints can by no means achieve this on their own, not by their efforts, in the midst of persecution and the opposition that they face. So God, continue to equip them with the courage, boldness, and zeal that they are desperately in need of in this time, to continuously persevere and run this race marked out before them with their eyes fixed on Christ, the author and perfecter of their faith. Let's pray.
Restore your peace.
Sovereign Lord and King over all. We declare that you are Sovereign Lord and King over the nation of North Korea. Despite human rule and reign, no form of human government or leadership can take your place. To take your rightful place, O Lord, and be enthroned in the nation of North Korea. We ask that your will be done in North Korea as it is in heaven, so that ultimately your plans and purposes for this nation will continue to be unfolded and established. Nothing can thwart your plans. We ask that ultimately a greater revelation of your kingdom would be released in this nation by people coming into true repentance and salvation so that they would acknowledge you as King. Let's pray.
As a Lord of Lords. as the Lord of lords. Come establish your throne. Come and take your place as a King of kings, as the Lord of lords. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All all other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name. Establish your throne. Come and take your place as the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Come establish your throne. Come and take your place as the King of kings, as the Lord of lords. Come establish your throne. Come and take your place as a King of kings, as a Lord of lords. Come establish your throne. Come and take your place as a King of kings, as a Lord of lords. And all other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus. All other names will bow. All other names will bow. All other names will bow before the name of Jesus.
Father, we thank you that you hear our prayers in this place tonight, and that truly our prayers make a difference. Lord, that at the sound of our cries to you, God, you move. And Father, you release your angels from the heavens. And Father, that you continue to establish your kingdom in the nation of North Korea. Father, we ask that you continue to restore this land. Father, restore prayer and worship. Restore your presence. Restore your church and restore your throne. And continue to have your way. Father, we acknowledge that you are King and you are Lord over the nation of North Korea. Nothing will hinder, Father, even no schemes or tactics of the enemy will hinder, Lord, your plans. And so, Father, we come to you in faith tonight. We pray these prayers in faith, believing that you hear us and that you answer us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining us tonight. We hope that you've had a really great time in God's presence.